guys, Mower Innovations back for another video, and today we are working on neither the MTD or the Victor. Today we are working on this, and this is a 3.5 horsepower, 148cc, Briggs & Stratton push mower engine. Now, so the problem was, is what I wanted to do was make it run on kerosene. But like first I wanted to make it so that it was kind of more like a two-stroke lawnmower, but that idea failed because what happened was I originally filmed another intro, but that failed. It wasn't even on it wasn't on the movie setting on this camera. It was on the photo setting, so I took some photos. So what I've done is I've got my welder out and I've just welded on this other lobe here. Reasonable, it worked, until I discovered that lobe actually hits just here. It just hits it. I don't really want to go around cutting stuff off, so that's what I'm going to do, because that's not my only camshaft. I have this one here as well. This camshaft in, but I'm going to take the exhaust, tap it out. I'm just not even going to put it in, and I'm going to cut some little holes. Just going to drill some holes in here, just around when the piston's at the bottom part of its stroke. I'm going to cut some holes so it exhausts just like a two-stroke. To do this, what I wanted to do is just get just snap a couple of the fins off. And then put that in like that, see how it goes. And I don't want to, but I might have to cut this, just cut this whole piece off, just so it can actually exhaust. But I'm not going to bother doing that because I don't really care, and this is just a project to see if it's going to run or not. If it does, hooray. If it doesn't, boo. But first I need to pull apart that engine and extract its piston, because apparently I haven't got any spare pistons, which is really weird because I used to have a whole stack of them. Alright, come. So we're back again, and now, I got the hiccups. I've taken the piston out of that engine, cleaned it up a bit, pretty different, and I've started snapping the fins off, and I have selected the biggest robot I own. This one, to work as the exhaust port. So, yeah, I'll be back in a minute. So I've drilled the hole. I just drilled four separate holes, I think. And just drilled in between them. We've got us a nice slot now. So I got the file and just went in there and just cleaned up all the burrs. There's still some there, but it's a lot better. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my engine degreaser, wherever it is, and clean out all the gunk that's in there. I have no idea what the hell it is. Here, it's just bits of particles and shit. I don't care though. The internals are the most important part, and the outside parts don't really have to be too clean. It's pretty cool, I've got aluminum shavings off. Looking nice. Valve, no tappet in there, and this is the intake valve. Yes, there is a tappet in there. I'm not sure if you can see, but the piston, it's just like two stroke. Yeah, sure, it's going to cover the soil some plate with disgusting goodness, but that's okay. So, we'll put this on. Right. Put the box on. Now, the reason why I'm making you watch this is to just show that, no, I'm not faking this. This is completely real. It's going to be interesting if it runs or not. I hope it will. So, it's going to be pretty bad for the environment. Just greenies out there, just don't watch this, alright? Alright, so yeah, I'll be putting it on the deck, on the mower deck. So I have, because that's something to hold it. And then, yeah, we'll be firing it up. I'll make sure I film that. Adios! So, yeah. Same engine. Same engine. It leaks oil. It's gonna be interesting. Yeah. So, let us pray. Fun. This is like. Oh, it's coming. Splattered in oil now. PCB boot. Haven't got one. Okay. I'll be back once I've sorted that out. Okay, sorted that out. Prime it again. Give it a whirl. So it really wants to go. The problem that I'm facing is when I start it, it starts fire. This retards the throttle. So, fix that. I need wire. my retarded little brother.
Shut up.
But,
we're gonna be retarded then. You were. Washer, and kind of just put it on there to use it as a choke. I think I might have choked it too much. I had it running for like 2-3 seconds, which is the longest I've had it running. So maybe if I completely cut the air off, except for the little PCB thing, we'll see how it goes. But for now, my renovations are great.